Hey guys, this is Abhishek from Technix Media. Today we are going to review LG Optimus 4X HD phone, which has been recently launched from LG here in India. This phone is going to come at a price range of around 34,000 Indian rupees. So let's talk about the phone. This phone has a capacitive IPS display with a screen size of around 4.7 inches diagonal, with a pixel density of around 312. And this phone runs Android Ice Cream Sandwich. Let me just show you the version of that, the exact version. Okay, so the exact version of Android which comes onto this device out of the box is 4.0.3. Talking about the phone looks very good. It comes in two colors again, white and black. This one is the black variant which we have right now. So taking a look on the phone, on the top side we have the power and sleep key here. And then we have a small hole for mic. This seems to be a secondary mic for noise cancellation. Then we have a 3.5 mm audio jack, which seems to be bulging out a little at the back side. On the left hand side of the phone, we have this plastic kind of volume rocker. And we have two chrome rings actually on the edges of the phone, which makes it look good. On the bottom, you have a port for micro USB cable connectivity. The cable comes within the box of this device. Here you have the primary hole for mic, as you can see here. On the right hand side of the phone, you have nothing, no buttons, as you can see. On the back side, you have an 8 megapixel camera with LED flash. Here you have the LG branding, and at the bottom you have the section for the loudspeaker. So this phone again comes with some of the pre-installed apps from LG. One of them is LG Smart World, which seems to be LG app store, from where you can install all these apps, all the apps designed specifically for this phone from the LG app store, which are provided by LG. Then you have the Smart Share app, which allows you to stream music, video from the DLNA capable devices using the Wi-Fi Direct feature onto this phone. Apart from this, you have a task manager as well, which is there inbuilt into the phone, which will allow you to kill all the apps at once like this. So talking about the front display, on the top you have a 720p capable front camera, which is good for video calling. Here you have the earpiece, and at the bottom you have the swap button for the home key, for the back key, and the properties key over here. The interface looks like very much similar to touchless UI. So let's open the back cover of this phone to see what is the battery capacity and other things. How does the phone look like when you remove the back cover? The back cover is again of plastic quality, but don't bend it because it has actually the NFC antenna in the back cover. These two are for the NFC, so make sure you handle the back cover properly. Don't bend it, otherwise you might damage the NFC part of the phone. So on the back side of the phone, you see the camera with LED flash. Here you have the slot for SIM card, the normal size SIM card, which can go into the slot. So here you have the slot for micro SD card, the memory card. And here you have the slot for normal size SIM card over here, which can go in here. But you won't be able to insert a SIM card unless you remove the battery. The battery capacity onto this phone is 2150 mAh, and at the bottom you see the loudspeaker mesh over here. So this is the battery model number, as you can see. Apart from this, the phone has Wi-Fi capability, Bluetooth 4.0. I'm not sure it has actually Bluetooth 4.0, so I will confirm that during my review. It has the NFC capability. Here you see the NFC antenna in the back cover integrated, and some other apps which are actually come pre-installed onto this device. One of them is Quick Memo, which you can access by sliding the notification bar and then tapping over the quick memo, and now you can add annotation onto the screen. You can buy a separate stylus which come from LG, but it comes separately. You will have to buy it separately. It doesn't come with the phone within the box. And then this is how you can write anything on a particular image or a screen which you want to share with your friends and family using this phone. Apart from this, it has the editable notification bar, wherein you can add different notification toggles. As you can see right now, it is the four default notification toggles which have been added into the notification panel. You can add more. So these are all the toggles which you can add, like the airplane mode toggle, the brightness toggle, with which you can easily increase and decrease the brightness, data toggle, data turn on off toggle for the GPS or 3G. Then you have NFC toggle and a portable Wi-Fi hotspot toggle as well, so that you can quickly use these features by adding the toggles onto the notification bar. So apart from this, this phone has regular every feature which you see in any other Android phone of this range. It has accelerometer sensor. It actually allows you to customize the icons as well. Here we have the official spec sheet from LG for this phone. So as you can see, this phone has 1.5 GHz quad core processor, 1 GB RAM. It runs on Android Ice Cream Sandwich 4.0.3 actually. The display size is around 4.7 inch, True HD 720p, 8 megapixel camera. The front camera is around 1.3 megapixel. And there is an LED flash at the back camera. Then you have the Optimus 3.0 UI onto this phone. The browser is based on Android WebKit browser, so it looks like the stock browser which is there. And it has an internal memory of around 16 GB, out of which around 14 GB approximately is available to the user. And it has a memory card slot as well, in which you can fit in maximum of 64 GB memory card, a micro SD card actually. And it also comes with BoxNet 50 GB free cloud storage. Then there are some regular features. It allows you to do full high definition video recording at 1080p using the back camera, the 8 megapixel camera. Then you have all these connectivity options. You have the TV out cable as well, which I am not sure either it comes within the box or you have to buy it separately. We will confirm that. Then you also get some NFC tags with this phone which you can use, and you can actually customize the functionality of those NFC tags. This phone also allows you to do the data backup and restore it once you have this. Let me just show you that. For the data backup, you need to go into settings. And here you find the backup and reset option. Under backup and reset option, you have the option of backing up my data to Google servers. And you can actually backup the data using the phone, either on the Google servers or to the computer, whatever you want. So talking about the other phones in the same segment, LG has also compared this phone with the other segment in this particular price range. Here they have like compared it with HTC One X and Galaxy S3. So HTC One X have the same diagonal size capacitive touchscreen, which is 4.7, and this device also comes at 4.7 touchscreen. Although S3 has a 4.8, little bigger touchscreen. Then it is based on square design with metallic accents. I don't know like what do they actually mean by this. Still, they have their own methodology, and it has a 1.5 gigahertz quad core processor, and it has 16 GB inbuilt memory, 50 GB cloud storage, which comes free with this phone once you buy it. Then you have the battery, which is around 2150 mAh, milliampere hour, which is higher than HTC One X as well as than S3, the Samsung Galaxy S3. Then you have these applications which actually seems to be inspired from S3 or any other phone, like the quick memo edit. The editable notification is actually a kind of a unique feature which they have actually came up with, although the quick memo seems inspired. Then you have gesture zoom, and then you have an icon customizer. You have the data backup and portable Outlook support onto this phone as well. So that's all from us regarding the quick review of LG Optimus 4X HT. This looks like a good phone. We will come up with a detailed review soon once we get this device for a review, for a detailed review actually. Thanks for watching this video. I hope you like this video. If this video actually helped you, please click the like button and do subscribe to our YouTube video channel if you want to watch more videos like this. And I hope to see you in my next video. Thanks for watching. Thank you.